Hi, YouTube family.
My name is Elysia English.
And I'm Philip English.
Welcome back to our channel.
Yesterday, we got in the bathroom and Elysia painted the vanity this absolutely gorgeous blue, and it's giving us all the nautical vibes.
I'm super excited to get back in there today because we are actually doing an upcycle in that bathroom space. I know we're gonna spend a lot of time in this camper, and we promised you guys when we did this camper that we would do everything on a budget. And so that's exactly what we're doing for this bathroom space. We're also gonna talk a little bit in today's video about how much we've spent so far on the renovation of the camper. You guys have been asking. I said we would do a complete total at the end of the renovation, but we're about 3/4 of the way through and I thought it was perfect time to do a bit of an update. Let's get working.
On yesterday's camper episode, you saw that we got the ceiling up and it looks absolutely gorgeous, almost seamless. There's just one little line of seam there, one seam there, one seam there.
Sounds like
there.
A lot of seams,
Phil. Only a couple. We're gonna try and get the bathtub in. Ooh, look at that. Ooh, the color is just absolutely gorgeous. What color is it?
It's called Majestic Mountains.
Majestic Mountains. But the mountains are giving me all the coastal vibes.
So out of our main floor bathroom that we're renovating on the inside of our house, we actually removed the backsplash or tub surround out of that bathtub. So I don't really want to throw it out because there really isn't anything wrong with it other than the fact that it's outdated. It's not cracked, doesn't have any chipping or anything. And so I thought, why can't I just restore that and use it on the wall surrounding the tub in the camper? It's a trial. I'm not really sure if it's going to fit or if it's going to work. But I thought rather than spending money on more plywood for the idea that I did have for that space, I kind of wanted to do this subway tile cut like I did in the kitchen space, but that would require me to buy more materials. And since we're trying to do this on the budget, I just thought, why not try using the backsplash that I already have? We're going to see if it fits. It's almost the perfect width all the way across.
Really?
Look at it. It's like, look at that much is to spare.
Oh my god.
And
gosh.
There's a corner piece, so then you won't even see that. Okay, that is ideal. Okay, let me see. The bathtub goes to there.
Wow.
Which if the shower head's here, it'll be a nice shower wall.
Perfect.
It's the perfect width. How did I get so lucky on that? Hold up just a minute. Been looking for some help just to find myself. I'm going to stand these up in the sun and let them dry. That way I'm not wasting any paper towels or anything. And then we'll be able to take our measurements to see what is going to fit exactly in the bathroom space, how we're going to do the side walls.
Elysia is just scraping away a lot of the old caulking. Either we do it out here or we do it inside the camper. Less mess inside, let's do it outside.
Give it another quick spray down, I think, right?
Yeah, give it another quick spray down. What a genius idea, though. I would never have thought of that. I would have thrown these out.
That's what you have me for!
I know, I would have thrown these out, not thinking reuse. What a perfect application for them.
I didn't know that would be the right length screw, so I need some more. Oh, I don't remember where I put it. Pocket full.
It looks amazing.
Well, it looks not too bad. It'll look good when I'm done. This material was actually thin enough, but still super durable because it's been in a bathroom for years and years. But we had an arch at the top that had to come all the way down, then it's kind of on an angle, then it comes out straight and goes all the way down. But because it's flexible enough, I'm able to get that super tight up against that arch there and then change the direction of the wall as it kind of works its way down. So this is really amazing. And I actually think if I would have actually cut them out on the plywood pieces like I thought, I wouldn't have been able to accomplish that look that is already the shape of the bathroom. We're not reconfiguring the shape of this bathroom. So this is actually working out to be really good. There's literally so many of them back there. I'm gonna get them all. We'll be driving down the road and we'll hear screws tinking around at the bottom of the bathroom. I think if I get this painted, then we can do our trim edge, which since it's very similar to the material of this, I think we'll be able to bend it around the curve. I think I'm gonna try to cut this material with my tin snips. Do you think that will work, Philly? Paint? Time for paint. Okay, so I've decided. I tried cutting this actual material of the backsplash tub surround material. What is it made out of? I don't even know. Very difficult to cut. I tried cutting it with tin snips. I tried cutting it with several different things. Nothing will cut it without it cracking. I'm going to probably get some quarter like rubber filler from the hardware store that actually is sort of like a trim that can go all the way around the edges, since I was just a little short from the width here. That'll actually look really nice and it will seam the water from getting in that spot anyway. So I'm gonna paint this. Probably take a few coats. I'm making a mess already. Was your mind that I wanna know? A penny for your thoughts. I didn't take off the rest of this because I'm going to put a trim seam here before we do a large mirror. So you aren't going to see this. And I thought since this is already like that water membrane stuff, really there's no point in peeling the rest of it off. I'd rather it be there for the water membrane.
I wasn't gonna argue with you.
Insert what day is it clip here.
All of them.
All of them.
I wonder how many times I've actually said what day is it on our channel. I have no idea.
A lot. I have to do several coats of this, so we're gonna have to let it probably dry overnight since this is a special paint. And then we'll be able to get the seams and stuff in there and then get the tub and everything put back in.
We have two coats in on this, what I would say was a perfect backsplash. And we're gonna let this dry and then keep putting more coats on.
Little more progress done in the bathroom today. I'm really happy with the way we were able to upcycle some stuff from our interior bathroom of our house. Didn't really want to throw that to the landfill when there was nothing wrong with it, but we definitely need an update on our inside bathroom. So being able to use some of those supplies was not only a way to save money on the camper renovation, but also save things from being in the landfill. So a little leftover paint and this piece from the bathroom and a few screws, and we're just gonna get a little bit of trim piece up the sides, and that part is finished. So we have a few more coats of paint to do on that, but we're gonna leave it for 24 hours and then get in there and get a couple more coats on that. But another bit progress done. We wanted to talk to you guys about a question we constantly get asked is, how much money have you spent on the camper?
We originally went to purchase this camper for $1,500. When we got there, we talked them down to $1,300 and we thought that was a pretty good deal. Grabbed the trailer, hooked her up, brought the trailer home.
We knew that we were probably going to spend probably between $1,500 and $2,000 approximately on fixing up the camper. But there was a few pieces and elements of this camper that we knew we weren't going to cheap out on and that we weren't really going to upcycle, which was countertops in the kitchen, since right. We're going to utilize the kitchen space a lot, and a clean countertop is a must. The countertop that was there was in a million pieces. It was made out of the garage sanded flooring material. It was terrible.
It was gross. It had to go.
Yeah, and we wanted to get nice flooring for the camper because we felt like really nice flooring throughout would not only be easier to clean and wipe up when we have kids and pets, but also it was going to give a big impact on what the final reveal looked like of the camper.
Do you remember when you walked in here and you looked down and you're like, two-tone floor, really?
They had gorgeous hardwood in here, super, super heavy, and two different colors, which just wasn't doing it for me. So thanks to Home Hardware, we were able to get gorgeous flooring and gorgeous countertop for a really small budget. So we actually did the countertops and the flooring in here for under $300, which is a great deal. We have invested $1,300 for the camper, $300 for flooring and countertop, and another $1,100 in all of our other supplies. So we are way under budget right now on what we planned for the camper.
Yes.
And we have a lot of leftover materials, which we already have purchased to finish the remainder of the camper.
Yep.
So we haven't even really dipped into all of the supplies that we bought. So I'm really happy with that. One of our biggest expenses has been the amount of paint that we've needed to work on the camper.
Yeah.
Exterior and inside paint has actually added up, and we've needed a lot more than we thought that we would. So if you're planning on renovating a camper, just know how much time and money it's going to cost you in paint alone. That has really been a big impact for us, and we're using really good quality paint. Just wanted to update you on that. We will do a breakdown at the end reveal of the camper explaining exact breakdown on what we've spent on everything, so that if you're working on a camper renovation yourself, you'll know approximately what it's going to cost you to do different things. Keep in mind, we also repaired some leaks and some other minor repairs in this camper.
There were things that when we grabbed the camper, we didn't know when we just did our walkthrough and did our peek around. We have never purchased an old camper before either, so we didn't know what to look for.
We really didn't know what we were getting into.
Then when we brought it home, we were finding out that it wasn't wasn't just a spot on the floor. The whole floor had to come up and new subfloor had to go down. And it wasn't just a little leak on the roof. It was a lot of the leak on the roof and that had to be fixed. All that wood had to be replaced. Things that we had no idea that we'd be getting into.
So far, we've really enjoyed doing this. And yes, we wouldn't take back our initial purchase.
No.
$1,300 Canadian dollars for a camper, even though it's a super old one, we think it's a goodie and we're happy to put a little bit of money and a lot of time into this.
And a whole lot of love.
A whole lot of love. Our boys are going to love this and we know that when we get this to its final resting space and travel with this with the kids, it's going to be amazing for our family. Thank you guys so much for being part of our camper series. We always have such a wonderful response from you guys and having you guys part of our journey on transforming this has been really awesome. You guys keep sending us pictures of campers that you've been inspired by us to renovate, progresses on what you guys are working on, which is super awesome. So we appreciate all the feedback that we've been getting. We love you guys. Thank you so much. We will see you on tomorrow's episode.
Bye.
Bye.